There are a lot of Twitter settings you need to change as soon as you create an account.
We're going to tell you about a setting that Twitter hides from iPhone and iPad users.
Like me?
Like you, and like me. And we're gonna tell you about all the Twitter settings that collect tons of data about you.
This video is for Android and iPhone users. Let's start with that setting Twitter is hiding from people like us.
If you've ever been on Twitter and saw a tweet that was hidden because it contained sensitive content, there is a setting that's preventing you from seeing it.
And here's the frustrating part. You can't change it using the Twitter app on iPhone or iPad, but you can using the Twitter app on Android or on the Twitter website.
Let's open Safari and go to Twitter. I'm already logged in, so what I'm gonna do is tap my account icon, upper left-hand corner of the screen, scroll down and tap Settings and Support, then scroll down and tap Settings and Privacy. Then we're going to tap on Privacy and Safety, we'll tap on Content You See, and make sure the check mark appears next to display media that may contain sensitive content.
Now that David can see all the sensitive content he's been looking for, let's talk about the ways Twitter collects a lot of data about you.
We're gonna go through the rest of this video in the Twitter app. So let's close out of Safari by swiping up from the bottom of the screen. Let's open the Twitter app and tap on your account icon in the upper left-hand corner of the screen. Tap Settings and Privacy, then tap Privacy and Safety. Scroll down to Add Preferences and turn off the switch next to Personalized Ads.
When this is on, Twitter can personalize the ads you see based on your activity within the app and based on your activity when you're engaged with their partners.
We recommend turning off personalized ads everywhere. People are afraid they're gonna see low quality spam ads, but that's just not true.
You won't, because major tech companies like Twitter don't let low quality advertisers into their ad networks.
But with Elon at the helm, Twitter has lost $20 billion in value. Maybe the ads you see will be a little bit lower quality than usual.
Surprise, that's not the only way Twitter collects data about you.
Let's tap back, upper left-hand corner of the screen. One below Add Preferences is Inferred Identity. Let's tap on that and turn off the switch.
What the heck is Inferred Identity?
When this is on, Twitter can personalize your experience based on your activity on devices you haven't even used to log into Twitter.
That's a little sketchy, and we're still not done.
Let's tap back, upper left-hand corner of the screen. Scroll down, below Inferred Identity is Data Sharing with Business Partners. Tap on that and turn off the switch.
When you turn this off, makes sense, cuts down on the amount of data Twitter shares with their business partners. Who are they? As the kids say, sounds sus to me.
We're really trying hard to appeal to the younger demographic.
This next setting is a privacy issue and a battery drainer.
Double whammy. Let's tap back, upper left-hand corner of the screen. Below data sharing with business partners is location information. Let's tap on that. First thing to do, turn off the switch next to personalized based on places you've been.
When big tech companies use phrases like personalized content, what they're really talking about is advertising, and that presents a privacy issue.
Let's say I hand somebody my phone and I show them a tweet. They start scrolling through my feed and they see, oh, you've been recommended this content because you've been to this certain place. Now they know I've been there and they can maybe start following me around and see all the places that I go.
Like my favorite Dr. Seuss book, Oh, the Places You've Been.
But this next setting is a huge battery drainer. It's precise location. Let's tap on that. Right now it's enabled. How precise does your Twitter location really need to be?
Does Twitter need to know exactly where you are? And remember, the more precise your phone hones in on your location, the more battery it uses. So this is also asking, how much battery do you want the Twitter app to be able to use?
I don't want Twitter collecting and storing my precise location. I'm gonna turn that switch off.
Before we talk about a very important security setting, we hope you'll take a moment to subscribe to our YouTube channel. It helps us out a lot.
Or since you're already on Twitter, consider following at PayItForward, at David Lynch, YT. The discrepancy between our YouTube subscribers and our Twitter followings is massive. So help us balance out that ratio. Follow us on Twitter, links in the description section.
Next up, two-factor authentication. This is super important for social media apps like Twitter and YouTube. Even the biggest creators like Linus Tech Tips getting hacked all the time.
One of the best ways to protect your account is by turning on two-factor authentication in the Twitter app. Let's tap back to the main Twitter settings page. Tap on Security and Account Access, tap Security, and then tap two-factor authentication.
You have three options. Kind of. Elon has decided that if you aren't going to pay $8 a month for the blue checkmark, he's not going to let you use SMS authentication.
And unless you already have a security key, your best bet is probably an authenticator app like Authy or Google Authenticator.
But beware, there are a lot of fake authenticator apps out there. And in case you're not familiar with how these apps work, we're going to show you how to set it up right now.
Let's turn on the switch next to authentication app. I'll enter my Twitter password. It says protect your account. I'll tap get started. Link the app to your Twitter account. So I'll tap link app. And when Authy is installed on your phone, you just save that account nickname, tap save. It gives you this code. You can tap this copy button in the lower right-hand corner, copy to clipboard. It expires in 19 seconds. I better hurry up here. Let's tap back to Twitter. Enter the confirmation code. I'll tap in the space. I'll tap again, and then I'll tap paste, and I'll tap confirm. And now I'm all set. It also gives you a single use code to save in a safe place. Fortunately, I'm recording this video on my phone. So
we've all got it.
We've all got it. Everyone's got it. Hopefully it's blurred out on the screen right now and you can't break into my Twitter account.
As I said, and especially since Elon decided to shut off SMS authentication for the masses, there are a bunch of fake authenticator apps. So check the description section below. We'll link to Authy on both iPhone and Android.
This next setting will help you save cellular data and battery life. Let's tap back upper left-hand corner of the screen. Back again, back one more time. Scroll down and tap accessibility, display, and languages, then tap data usage, then tap video autoplay and set that to only on Wi-Fi.
This will save you a lot of cellular data and battery life because it's not going to just start autoplaying videos that you don't even want to see. Why is this in the accessibility section of the Twitter app? I don't know.
And there's another important Twitter setting you need to know to save some storage space on your phone. Let's tap back upper left-hand corner of the screen. Below video autoplay, we have media storage and web storage. These are Twitter's caches. So if I tap into media storage, for example, I can clear the media storage, tap clear media storage. If you haven't done this in a while, don't be surprised if these numbers are really, really high. I've got like 30 megabytes in both. But if you never cleared these caches before, it could be huge. I'll do the same thing for web storage. Tap on web storage, tap clear all web storage, and then tap clear all web storage.
It's a good idea to clear the Twitter caches every once in a while. But bear in mind, it's normal for the caches to grow over time as you use the app.
There's an iPhone-specific Twitter setting we need to change, but first, an important setting for every Twitter user to know about in case of a PR nightmare. Let's tap back to the main Twitter settings page, tap privacy and safety, tap audience and tagging, and look at this protect your tweet switch.
When you turn this setting on, it keeps your Twitter account private so that only people who have already followed you can see your tweets. And moving forward, you have to manually approve new followers.
Very handy in the case you tweet something stupid, you get dunked on and you get embarrassed.
People are linking to you from Newsweek.
Yeah.
People, how could he have said that?
Shut it down. Before we tell you about that important iPhone setting, we want to tell you about our channel memberships. When you join this channel, you'll get things like member shoutouts, PDFs for some of our videos, custom badges and emojis, and a whole lot more. It's a great way to support us. Click that join button below this video.
And that important iPhone setting has to do with app tracking.
I'll close out of Twitter by swiping up from the bottom of the screen, come over here to the settings app, open that up, scroll down to privacy and security, then tap on tracking. Make sure that Twitter does not have the ability to track you across other apps and websites. It's a huge privacy issue. We just recommend turning the switch off at the top of the screen and then asking apps to stop tracking. Now, none of the apps installed on your phone can track you across other apps and websites, and in the future, new apps will be able to either.
But it's not just Twitter that's the problem. All the big tech companies are tracking us across other apps and websites. So watch our next video about every iPhone or every Android privacy setting you need to change now. We will see you there.